Experiments started, perhaps just for the fun of it, or to satisfy scientific curiosity, often lead to unexpected, useful results in fields that could not have been predicted.
Okay, what do I do with the carbon monoxide? No hood anywhere near. So I took a cork borer, carborundum powder, and carefully drilled a hole, small hole in the window pane, and put a tube out. Taylor came around, looked at it, and said, "Who did this?" "I did, sir." He looked at it, he never said anything more. When I wasn't using it, I just put a cork in it. And some years ago, I happened to be in the lab, and the cork was, and the hole was still there.
Any good catalytic chemist knows that the first thing one has to consider is the thermodynamics of a reaction, because much time has been wasted trying to get catalysts which carry out reactions that are not thermodynamically possible.
There's no one common solution to all of these problems in catalysis, and I still believe in the dictum of Herman Pines that if you want to understand catalysis, you got to study a catalytic reaction.
That is, if component A is adsorbed more strongly than component B, then as the liquid penetrates the pores, the more strongly adsorbed component will be adsorbed on the surface preferentially. And so during the process of introducing the solution into the pores of the support, you get a sort of chromatographic separation.
I can make you mine, taste your lips of wine. think it's always an adventure to ask a question and to enter a new field where you don't know the answer in advance. And if you then get an answer, and if this answer is really surprising, this creates a great joy, yeah, always.
Finding that I mentioned, in that case, the most excited.
Some new tools began to be introduced in catalysis.
Of the pore sizes and so on just was too tempting to ignore.
Tell you about some of the things we've been doing, looking at the integration of surface science methods into the study of catalysis. I need not tell this group that metal-supported catalysts, for example, very complex materials, very difficult for us as surface scientists to apply many of the techniques. I mean, you can do.
Change at 77K on magnesium oxide. In fact, this to me was probably one of the first in situ EPR study in catalysis.
Holland, of course, has always been very, very heavily interested in catalysis. And
able to stabilize them, because as I said, finally they die.
Luxury to try and say, what the hell are we doing now? Let's try and understand the process.
Wasted.